Hi dear students, welcome back all of you to the physics online class. Yes, up to the last video we learnt the three chapters of the first PUC. So the last chapter was motion in a straight line. So as I have told earlier also, the motion in a straight line means way the body or a particle can travel in a one direction only. Yes, because there we discussed one direction, the straight line means it is considered to be one direction. That direction means in a one, the x-axis is considered means the particle has so two options here. One, it may move in the positive x direction, or the second, it may move in the negative x direction. But so today we are going to start the next chapter of the first PUC, that is a chapter number 4, motion in a plane. What is that? Motion in a plane. That means here we discuss about if the velocity, displacement, acceleration, force of a body is changing. Accordingly, if it is having two directions, actually in the previous class, that means in the previous chapter, only one direction it was changed. So that we called a rectilinear or motion in a one dimension, so we told. But here, we are going to study that whenever the object is changing its velocity or the acceleration or the force acted on that, it may have two directions. That is, one in a x coordinate, another one in a y coordinate. So, in order to understand how the object can move in a plane, how the object can move in a two dimension, we need to understand first the concept of the scalars and vectors here. Because this scalar and vector only can represent, that only can explain us how the object is taking motion in a plane. So, motion in a plane means, the motion, what is meaning of motion in a plane? The motion of an object which takes place in a two coordinate system. So, for understanding that, I can draw a diagram here. The motion in a plane can be represented as, one is taken as a x coordinate, another one is a y coordinate. So then can you restrict only the x and y? No. If you want y and z coordinate also you can take. If you want z and y coordinate or z and x coordinate. So in order to describe the motion of an object in a plane, minimum how many coordinates we need here? The two coordinates we need here. So here the between, see here, x and y coordinates are there and these two coordinate forming a plane here. So within that object may move here, 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 wherever it may move, its motion will be described with the help of the plane. So it is called motion in a plane. Am I clear? So what is a or? One more thing. This is also called motion in a two dimensional, because here the dimension, the particle may have along the x direction, the value may be along x direction or it may be along the y direction. So here two dimensions we are representing. So this motion of an object is also called as motion in a two dimensions. Am I clear? So the motion in a two dimension, what type of the motion is called as motion in a plane means? One is projectile motion. Any object which is thrown with the initial velocity under the action of gravity, that shows the motion in a plane. And the second one is the uniform circular motion. The uniform circular motion, that will also exhibit the motion in a plane. Then, to understand the point of projectile motion and how the projectile is moving and trajectory traced by the projectile, its expression for the different range, height, everything, we need to understand first the concept of the scalars and the vectors. Because in a motion in a plane, in order to study motion in a plane, we need the clear idea of the vectors and the multiplication of that vectors, and even scalars and the multiplication of the scalar. So let us start to learn about motion in a plane with the point of scalars and vectors. Okay? Yes. And see, dear student, this beginning part will help you a lot to understand what are the quantities are called as the scalars and what quantities are called as the vectors, how to differentiate between a scalar and the vectors, all the points. That is why in our physics, so many physical quantities we will learn in every chapter. Then in order to define whether that quantity is a scalar or a vector, that can be so represented by the study of this concept only. Yes? Then first I will explain you the concept of scalars. What are scalars? Yes, tell me, according to you, what are the scalars? Scalars are the physical quantities which have only magnitude, no direction. What are the scalars? Scalars are the physical quantities which have only magnitude but no direction, which have only the numerical value but no direction. Such a quantities are called as the scalar quantity. Andre, nodrappe, idara introduction, motion in a plane anta helbekadre, illivaregu naavu koneya chapter dalli yen kaltidivri, ondu vastu sarala rekeyalli yav riti chalisutte annodra bagge kalti. ಆ ಸರಳ ರೇಖೆಯ ಚಲನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಸ್ತು ಮುಂದಾದರೂ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದಿತ್ತು, ಅಂದರೆ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ದಲ್ಲಿ, ಹಿಂದುಗಡೆ ಆದರೂ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದಿತ್ತು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ದಲ್ಲಿ. ಆದರೆ ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತು ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಒಂದು ಸಮತಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ಗಳ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನೇ ಮೋಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಟೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾಕಪ್ಪ ಇದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೊಜೆಕ್ಟೈಲ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು, ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ನಿರ್ದಿಷ್ಟ ಆರಂಭಿಕ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿಯ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಎಸೆದಿವಿ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊರಿ, ಅದು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿಯ ಒಂದು ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಎಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಾನು ತೊಗೋಬೋದು, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಪುಟನ್ನು ನೀವು ಒಗೀತೀರಿ, ಯಾವುದು ಗುಂಡು ಎಸೆತ, ಚಕ್ರ ಎಸೆತ, ಬಲ್ಲ ಎಸೆತ, ಇಂಥವೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಎಸ್, ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಎಸೆಯಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಎಂಗಲ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಸೆದ್ವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಹೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕಡಿಮೆಯಾಗಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ದೂರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ಲೇಟರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟನ್ನು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ಸೊ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ದು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗಕತ್ತದರಿ, ಮೋಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟು, ಹೌದಾ? ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಸೊ 400 ಮೀಟರ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಒಂದು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಇತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ 400 ಮೀಟರ್ ಓಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಒಂದು ಅಥ್ಲೆಟ್ ಓಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸದ ಸುತ್ತಲೇನ ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೋಷನ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಓಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಓಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ಆ್ಯಂಗಲನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟರೆ ಅವನು ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಮತ್ತು ರನ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟನ್ನು ರೀಚ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಈ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಕ್ಟೈಲ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ನಮಗೆ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಸೊ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಗಳನ್ನು, ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ ಆಯಿತು, ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ನಮಗೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಉಪಯೋಗ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ. ಸೊ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ಸ್? ದ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್, ನೋ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓವರ್, ಸೊ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್. ಆಮ್ ಐ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್? ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ. ಎಸ್, ದ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. distance is taken to be a scalar. Why the distance is scalar? Because see, how much far you have traveled means you will mention that today I traveled, I walked, I moved with the so value of 20 kilometer, 30 kilometer, 2 kilometer, like that we mention to the number and a unit. So in the first chapter itself I told you any physical quantity can be expressed in terms of the numerical value and its unit, isn't it? So the distance is taken to be scalar quantity. Why it is a scalar? It gives only me the magnitude. We will not take that as a particular direction here. So the quantities which have only magnitude, no directions, they are called a scalar quantities. Am I clear, dear students? So many of the example we can take here. Distance is a scalar, mass is a scalar. Yes, here also. See, what is the mass? How much, if you go to the shop, grocery shop, and ask there, give me the sugar, they may give you immediately sugar. They ask you how much quantity you need. By the time you will say that half kg, 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg. Are you telling there? Are you asking there 2 kg in the north direction, 2 kg downward, 2 kg upward, like that? Have you mentioned there the so direction? No, mass has only the numerical value, no particular direction. So that also taken as scalar quantity. The next one, time is also a scalar quantity. Whenever any person, anybody will ask you what is the time, you just mention what is the numerical value. Now the time is 2 o'clock, 2:15, like that we are mentioning the numerical value. We won't say that the time is 2 o'clock towards the east direction, towards the west, like that we will not mention, isn't it? So that only, any quantity which has only the numerical value, no particular direction, that is called as the scalar quantity. Yes, and usually scalars are represented so with the small letters only. If you want to write a scalar quantity, then that is represented with the small letters. For example, I have taken that as a general scalar. So if you want particularly distance, means for that you can take either D or a X as the only the representation of the scalar. Okay, mass means there you take a small m, and time means there you will take small t. These are the representation of the scalars. Yes, and many examples are there. Just I have given 3 here. Temperature is also taken as a scalar quantity. Temperature is a scalar quantity. Work is a scalar quantity. Power is a scalar quantity. Yes, and pressure is also taken as a scalar quantity, etc. Like this, many examples we have which are only magnitude. They are called scalars. Okay, then moving to the next one, that is a vectors. Right, what are the vectors? Vectors antandre enappa? See, here they have only magnitude. Then if they have direction also, what they are called? They are called as the vectors. The quantities which have both magnitude and the direction, they are called as the vector quantities. Yes, the quantities which have both magnitude and direction, both magnitude and direction, isn't it? So they are called as the vectors. Then the examples, example, see which quantity have the magnitude and the direction? The displacement has a magnitude and direction. Displacement, because see in the definition also we have seen that displacement means it is a shortest distance between initial and the final position. Initial and final, like that we are mentioning here the particular direction, isn't it? And if this displacement only changing with respect to the time, which quantity is obtained there? The quantity obtained is the velocity. Yes, velocity is also having both magnitude and the direction. So that is also called the vector quantity. Yes, if the velocity is changing with respect to the time, which quantity is obtained there? Acceleration. The quantity obtained is acceleration. That is also vector quantity. Okay, then if the acceleration is multiplied with the mass, the quantity obtained is a force. That is a force. So force is also vector quantity. Like this, many quantities are there, the physical quantities which have both magnitude and the directions, they are called as the vector quantities. Am I clear, dear students? Okay, so like this, so force, and then next you can take a linear momentum, and next angular momentum, many quantities are there, torque, etc. Many quantities are there, they are considered to be vector quantity. Yes, then how to represent a vector quantity? Generally, the vector is represented with a straight line with the arrow mark. Keep it in your mind, dear students. If we write, arrow mark, that is a straight line with the arrow mark on any so other quantities, that represent a vector quantity. Okay, because so this value means, if I am writing this letter, this only identifies that it has only magnitude. But the straight line with the arrow mark, that shows that this quantity also has the particular direction here. So the quantity with the magnitude and the direction is called as the vector quantity. And normally, to represent the vector, we are using the bold letters. Bold letters will be used. Yes, and for the displacement, I can write like this, x bar. Yes, and for the velocity, we can represent v bar. How it is pronounced? V bar. Yes, and next one, acceleration. For that, we use a bar. Next, force, f bar. Like this, whichever quantity we have used here, for that particularly we can write the vector form of the respective physical quantities. I hope you understood. Yes, so particularly remember. And one more, here in the scalars, magnitude means you can also write like this, the two parallel lines which are taken. So besides that quantity, that can give the magnitude. So the same here also, if you want to write the vector in the magnitude form, then also you can take like this, the magnitude of the vector. Because whenever we talk about the vectors, vectors may be having the direction positive, negative, or sometimes zero also. Okay, but when you are talking about the scalars, always they have the particular value, that is a positive value only. Therefore, when we were distinguishing between the velocity and the speed, distance and displacement in the previous chapter, there particularly I noted that distance is a scalar quantity and the displacement is a vector quantity. Because the displacement may be positive, negative, or zero, but the path covered by the object is always positive. We are not taking that as a zero, isn't it? Yes. So this is a what about the scalars and the vectors, right? Yes. Then let us discuss now how to differentiate. Hardly two differentiation we can give for the scalars and the vectors here. Yes. And the first one, difference between scalar and the vectors. First difference is scalar, which has only magnitude. the quantity which has only magnitude. Okay, and a vector means what? Which has both magnitude and direction. Has both magnitude and direction. And the scalar is always positive. This is always positive. Scalar quantities which we consider, they will be always positive, but the vectors which may be positive, negative sometimes, or sometimes zero also. Yes, and next difference is, as I told, the scalars are represented with the small letters, right? So here for the displacement I can use only x, for the speed I can use only v. These are the representation, but the vectors are represented with a letter with arrow mark on his head. So its head will be having the arrow mark, that is for the displacement, velocity, acceleration. We can represent a vector quantity with arrow mark on its head. Am I clear? So these are the few differences what we can give for the scalars. And one more last example you can give, that is example for that, as I told, distance, speed. The basic examples we can take, many are there as I given here. So two examples we can mention here, displacement and the velocity. Displacement and velocity. Am I clear? So I hope you understood the concept of the scalars and vectors, right? So this is a chapter, and see dear student, this chapter carries total weightage of marks 8. So how is the possibility to get the question? One, maybe particularly 5 marks you may get the numerical. Maximum possibility you have here to get one numerical, that is problem anna padiyuvanta, so possibility late numerical. Adan bitre innu 3 marks ell baruttappa antandra theory part dalli, either derivation they may ask or 2+1 ee riti keluvanta possibility nu irutte. Adakoskara amale ee vanda chapter bahala important ri, yakappa andre this gives the basic idea about all the scalar, vector, their product. If the vector is multiplied with any number, what quantity is obtained, how many types of the vectors are present, how to represent them, and later it also describe us what are the projectile and how they show their range, height, time of flight. If any object is thrown vertically upward with the initial velocity, projected with the initial velocity, how that describe, what is the nature of its path, all the things, everything we will discuss in this chapter. Okay, so I hope you are understanding the chapter, and in the next video we will talk about how are types of the vectors and how to represent that respective vectors, and we study the multiplication of scalars and the vectors. Okay, so I hope you are understanding. So thank you for watching my video.